Great rock and roll is usually made by people who don't have a home. You know, they're looking for some place to be, some place to go, some place to literally call their own.
Highly educated, well-read, smart people. And they brought a mixture of music that was not just three chords.
It was difficult, you know. I mean, you know, many times I said, why can't he just be a regular guy? I mean, you know, you can still write great songs and not be so crazy and, you know, go and do these weird things. But then again, I knew that, no, you can't. You know, guys like that are the ones that they kind of set the boundaries for the rest of us, you know.
You don't have to be an existentialist to get what is singing about in those songs. It's a universal truth in some ways, I think, that we all feel alienated from each other and from our own beings at time. And he just cut to the core and put it right there in his music.
It was attractive to a lot of people, to a lot of young people who were maybe a bit confused about their place in the world. Because I think they saw him and they heard his music and they heard somebody who was equally confused and unsure of their place in the world.
He was, you know, he was a reporter in a way. He wasn't just writing about himself any more than John Lennon was or Bob Dylan. And he took all of this stuff and he made it sound like he was singing about you.